What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're going to take a look at getting Alan Wake 2 to run here on the Steam Deck, and it's certainly not the best experience when it comes to graphics, gameplay, and really a lot of crashing issues going in and out of save points, which we'll talk about much later on in the video as well. This isn't the only way to get this game working. It just happens to be the way I got it to work. Steam Deck Gaming also has a video out. We collaborated a little bit figuring out some of this stuff, doing Heroic to get this to work. So I'll leave a link in the description to go check that out as well. But in here, I kind of want to go through all the steps I took to really get this to work here. Now, of course, you do have to be running Epic Games because this isn't on Steam, unfortunately, which would probably solve a lot of our problems. So we'll go through how to get Epic Games if you don't already have it. Also, I had to use the preview update channel, which is 3.5.1 currently at the time of making this video, to get it to really work stable was giving me even more trouble. You also need to make a change in BIOS to VRAM, which I'll show you how to do as well later on in the video if you don't already know, because this game requires 16 gigabytes or over 15 of system RAM or it won't launch at all. It doesn't seem to care about the VRAM size, so unfortunately we got to bring that down to launch the game. So let's get into it a little farther here, starting on desktop mode, where I'm going to use the non-Steam game launcher I've made a guide for, and I'll put a link as well in the description for you to go to that. A full setup guide for this, for setting up third-party launchers on your Steam Deck and getting those to work. But for this video, I will go ahead and include a small guide here of just quickly getting Epic Games to work for those of you that don't already have Epic installed or don't know how to. There will be timestamps in the video if you guys already know how to do certain things and want to jump around here. But anyways, click download, get non-Steam games launcher here, and then we're going to go ahead and minimize Mozilla here. We're going to go into our Explorer. We're going to go to downloads. I'm going to go ahead and move non-Steam games over to my desktop. I don't want to accidentally get rid of that. It's easier to run it from there. Close this out, and then we're going to double click. This is going to bring up for our install. We're going to click continue, and then we're going to get a full list of all the things we can install here, which is super handy. Really enjoy using this, and I do have an updated guide coming out, even though I do have a previous one. Again, I'll link for you, but we're focused on Epic Games here, so I check mark that, click OK for the install. Don't need anything custom there, click cancel, and we'll wait and go through this quick process here. And then once that's done, it's going to automatically close out Steam because it's going to add Epic Games to Steam for you as a non-Steam game. It's going to close itself out, and then Steam will restart. And at that point, I'll be able to show you that we have Epic Games automatically added. Now, 99% of the time, that works great for my launchers. Sometimes it does fail to add them, and I'll show you how to correct that really quickly in this video as well. So here we have Epic Games did automatically show up here for me. So that is good here. We go into properties. Now, I do want to change compatibility because I did have to run experimental here along with everything else we need to do in this video to get Alan Wake 2 to work. So Proton experimental with Epic Games is what I want to keep running here with the preview channel ready to go. And if we click play, I'm able to launch for the first time, get logged in, download my game, and do all that from desktop mode. It's much easier. That way, when we go over to game mode, we can just open up Epic, launch the game, and be good to go. So anyways, got logged in, downloaded my game, did all that kind of stuff, ready to go. Now, the other thing is that we need to get into, I did tell you I'd show you how to add it if it doesn't automatically get added. So we go to home, show hidden files, go to local, go to share, come down here, and we'll go to Steam. We'll come down and go to Steam apps and compat data. And in here, you'll have your non-Steam launchers folder that keeps everything kind of neat and tidy and installs in here. So it's kind of easy to find PFX, Drive C, and then Program Files and Program Files 86 will have your launchers depending on which one has been installed. So Epic will be under Program Files 86. There it is, Epic Games. You would go to Launcher, Portal. This will be different for different launchers, binaries, Win64, and then you would come down and find the launcher EXE, and then you could right click on that and add to Steam right away. And that's if it didn't automatically add it for you. This is just an example of how you can do that if you need to with this launcher or any others. It's usually not too bad. All right, so the other thing we need to do before we're done with desktop mode is Proton Tricks. This allows us to install different packages, Windows DLL, and all that kind of stuff. So you go into Discover. If you don't already have Proton Tricks, you can go to all applications, search it, and install it. But I have it right here, so we're going to go ahead and launch that. And it'll show Epic Games here that we've added with non-Steam game launcher. So highlight that, click OK. Then we're going to do the first default option here. Select the default Wine prefix, install a Windows DLL or component. I've already done these, so they'll be checked off, but that'll be easier to show you here. So we go into OK, and then you're going to want this D3 decompiler 43 and 47 checked off, and then come down to the bottom, VC run 2022, which is your Visual C. Click OK, and the Visual C will have two install prompts you'll go through. It'll just take a minute or two, and then you'll be able to close out of this, and you'll be done installing those. Now that VRAM and BIOS, if you don't know how to change that, you're going to hold up on your volume button and then hit the power button. Keep holding up on that volume button, though, until the menu shows up. Once our menu shows up here, bottom right, setup utility, we're going to go in there, bring us to our BIOS, bring it a little closer. We'll go down to advanced and UMA frame buffer size. 256 is what we're going to need, the lowest we can set, unfortunately, but that allows enough system RAM to be shown when we're booted up for Alan Wake 2 to actually launch and not just fail due to not having enough system RAM. So you got to do that as well. Once we do all that, we are done with desktop mode, we're done with the BIOS, and we are here back in game mode. We are using Proton Experimental. Double check that, that doesn't change on you. We'll go ahead and click here to launch Alan Wake 2. We'll use our cloud save, which is supported this way. I don't think cloud saves are supported through Heroic if you go that route. So that's just something to note. However, I don't know which route is more stable. You might get this warning as well. You can just click OK about the HDD. And other than that, you should be able to launch right in at that point. So I don't want to go too crazy with game performance, but we'll take a look here and we're going to talk about those save crashes as well. Now it says 720, but I'm going to switch to 800p, FSR unbalanced, everything low or turned off, whatever I could do to keep things down, less pressure on the system and easier to run here. And while performance will of course be very hit or miss, and I didn't expect much out of this, honestly, it actually runs decently enough considering, and it doesn't look great of course with these graphic settings and the lower resolution and all that. It definitely helps when you're on the smaller deck screen versus maybe watching a video on a larger screen, but I was anywhere from 19 FPS up to about 40-45 depending on the area of the game I'm in, and that's just in the beginning 45 minutes before we get into heavier areas of this game later on and with Alan and combat and stuff like that, where I know performance is going to seriously tank, and I'm sure we'll be in the teens plenty of time. So that's just something to be aware of. I don't think this is a great way to play Alan Wake 2, but if you're wanting to dive in and try it, we do have these methods that at least are able to launch and run the game at all here. And I actually do find that part to be pretty impressive that we're able to pull that off at all. And there's lots of different areas of this game, the evidence board being one of them, where you solve different clues for cases and things like that and progress the story. And those run pretty well. And I haven't had the game crash transitioning out of areas, running around, doing really anything in my first 45 minutes to an hour here on the deck. The only crash has happened during my save issues, which we'll talk about. So yeah, performance kind of going to be all over the place, and I'm sure it's going to get much worse later. But for those of you that do want to dive into a guide like this and get the game working and play around with it, seems like we're able to do that for the most part. And this may or may not work for everyone. That's just the nature of the beast right now, trying to get something like this to work. Now, again, this doesn't look the best on these settings, but it is running. This area, of course, in town in the beginning of the game runs much better than the forest, which is so much more foliage and stuff like that going on. But it will dip as well. And like I said, it's going to be all over the place. It's just surprising that the game is really even able to run at all. Again, Steam Deck Gaming has a video doing this through Heroic. It's a little bit different process. If you want to check that out, I'll have that link in the description for you. I'll have a link to the non-Steam game launcher and to my guide for that I originally had up and all of that. Now, here's the save issue. If I leave this game, which has just auto-saved a couple of minutes ago right here, and we want to load back in, whether I want to do it right away or I restart my deck and come back, if I click continue, I will always get a hard crash, meaning the deck just freezes to a point that I have to just hold the power button down till it turns off. I've had this happen almost 2 dozen times in my 6 hours of working on this video and getting all of this to work. It's just not a great experience. I've even had it happen during the load in, but I'll show you what works best. If I restart my deck after that hard lock and I come into load game and I pick my most recent load instead of continue, 99% of the time, it seems like so far, it will go ahead and load me back into my game, fortunately. And cloud saves do seem to be working. I'm able to go log in on my PC or GeForce Now, which is good. I'm not losing anything, but it just does crash and hardlock the deck a lot coming back in if you click continue. It seems like loading in picking a file to load in works better, but it doesn't work every time. And that's just something to note as well, because that's one of the biggest issues I have had with this once I did get it working. But anyways, guys, that's pretty much it. That's how I got Alan Wake 2 to work here. I'll try to have everything in the description for you as well, and the link to the other video to check out. And let me know if you guys give this a shot and how it works for you on your deck. All right, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it. I'll see you guys in the next one.